Yeah, it is a pretty remarkable story because, of course, Misrata is really an island enclave within Gaddafi territory. And you're absolutely right. It's a city under siege and a city where many people fear that there could be indeed be a massacre if, in fact, pro-Gaddafi forces do prevail here. Now, we have to say that the opposition forces there are badly outgunned. They have AK-47s if they're lucky. Most of them actually have makeshift weapons, things like machetes or guns that they've somehow manufactured themselves. And so, because of all the fighting that's going on in downtown Misrata, many people are trying to flee the city center, but they really don't have anywhere to go because that whole area is under siege. Here's what we saw when we were there. As heavy fighting rages in downtown Misrata, many residents have fled from the tank and artillery shells raining down on their neighborhood. But they have nowhere to run. The opposition-held city of Misrata is encircled by pro-Gaddafi troops. Masoud El Masoudi says he barely managed to get his family out of the city center and into the school on the outskirts. All the houses next to ours were knocked down in the fighting, he says. People were killed in the houses right next to ours, including women and children. Constant barrages of artillery, tank, and mortar fire have clearly traumatized especially the children. And as urban combat destroys more and more of downtown Misrata, many foreigners who came here to work during better times are now stranded. Some were hoping to leave via Misrata port, but they can't get out. So they've ended up here at a makeshift refugee camp near the port. It was set up when the fighting started and now stretches for several miles. All along the road leading to Misrata port, you find thousands of refugees, most of them from African countries, and they're stuck here. They're stranded here. They can't get anywhere. The worst thing about it is, first of all the refugee camps are makeshift. They have basically no food, no water that they're getting from the international community. What they're getting from the people of Misrata, and they're right in the middle of the combat zone. They gave us this piece of shrapnel. They say artillery shells fell right near the area where the refugees are. Cries for help have so far gone unheard as the situation of those caught here gets worse every day. While Misrata remains under siege, food, water, and medical supplies are further depleted and desperation grows.
And Wolf, one of the reasons why the people there are so afraid that a massacre could take place if the Gaddafi forces do prevail is that they're even shooting at humanitarian aid ships. The ship that we were on that was bringing food and medical relief to the port of Misrata, about 15 minutes after we left the port, there was heavy artillery shooting at exactly the position where that ship was. The artillery shells landed about 100 yards away from the ship that we'd been on about 15 minutes earlier. So it is a very, very difficult city to get into, and the people there are absolutely desperate, Wolf.
Did you see any evidence of NATO air support for these rebels, for the civilians in Misrata while you were there?
Yes, I did. We did hear some NATO planes overhead. There were some airstrikes that the opposition forces told us were taking place as we were there. Most of those happened sort of in the early morning hours and at night. You would hear planes overhead. Now, what they were telling us is that in recent days, NATO has been doing less shooting and more sort of overflight, surveillance overflights. One of the things that the opposition fighters told us is that they wish that the NATO planes would take more aim at Gaddafi's tanks, would be, if you will, less sort of afraid to take into account civilian casualties in case they do hit these tanks in the middle of the city. Of course, it's a very difficult undertaking because we know that Gaddafi is hiding his tanks under trees, is hiding them in schools and other areas. But the opposition forces say they would like to see more airstrikes rather than less. But we did see evidence of NATO planes overhead and also NATO planes striking targets in Misrata.
Yeah, I think there's been a change in the rules of engagement since NATO took full command as opposed to the United States. We'll continue to watch that part of the story. Fred, thanks for your excellent reporting.